Too bad the fog didn't give us water, right? Tonight, Governor Newsom has declared a drought emergency in two counties, and it could be just the beginning. Sonoma and Mendocino counties now under a drought emergency. Nearly the entire state is in trouble right now, but the governor stopped short of declaring a statewide drought. And in Marin County, with the hills parched, ranchers are concerned that grass-fed cattle won't have enough to feed on. Ranchers are already forecasting losses with no rain in sight.
It's kind of scary to see, to witness it. This is only April, you know?
So 2014 was bad. This is going to be worse.
As conditions persist and present themselves, to add other counties to that list as necessary.
Meteorologist Darren Peck is in for Paul this evening. And Darren, you were saying the snow is melting at a record pace right now in the Sierra.
Yeah, Liz, on the other side of the state, I've got some unprecedented changes to tell you about in the Sierra snowpack just over the last 3 weeks. Looks great when you look at it from space, but you're only seeing the surface level of the snow. What you have to consider is how much water is being stored in that snowpack. That's what matters most to us. On April 1st, when we did our big snow survey, we were at 63% of average. We'd like more, but that doesn't sound all that bad. But in the last 3 weeks, that number has gone down to 37% of average. It should have stayed close to 63. We're just talking about what's the percent of water there in comparison to what average would be for today's date. We were at 63% then. That number should have tracked closely to that. But something happened over the last 3 weeks. And if you look at the Sierra as a whole, I know the dots are small on there, but each one of the red dots shows you a snow sensor which has recorded the largest decline in water content in the Sierra snowpack since we started keeping records on this stuff, at least 30 years. So we're breaking records in terms of losing the snowpack faster than we ever have. The primary culprit behind this? The temperatures. And if you look at what California has done for the last 3 weeks, the areas shaded deeply in red were well above average. You may remember around April 1st, many of us here we're in shorts and t-shirt weather, and so it all ties into the story of climate change, which we're doing a lot of coverage on this week, and that's probably one of the more notable discoveries of just this last week. All right, let's come back to the forecast. Daytime highs today, mid-70s if you were inland, 58 in Oakland. Classic, getting into like a summer pattern around here. Morning lows tomorrow, no news. We'll go back down into the upper 40s. Expect the marine layer to build back in again overnight. We're going to wake up to gray skies for most of the Bay Area, but it'll burn back to the beaches by late morning and early afternoon. Let's talk about the more important change, and that gets here for the weekend. And the future cast is going to show us a very different pattern than what we've seen for the last several weeks. That is widespread rain coming to the Bay Area on Sunday. And this is 4 days out, so we're not going to get tied into specific details yet, but right now the forecast is going to be a general. It's going to rain Sunday, and it'll likely rain throughout the day. Widespread, steady rain in the morning, turning to scattered showers on Sunday afternoon. We pick up a quarter of an inch of rain for most of the Bay Area, and maybe a half an inch of rain in the Bay Area. These numbers are going to adjust a little over the next few days, but it's good that there's been consistency in the models for at least the last 24 hours on this idea. And look at the snow in the Sierra. This might be one of the bigger issues to make sure we are aware of. That's a foot of snow on Donner Pass falling on Sunday. This is the perfect situation to catch people off guard because so many people are thinking we're done with this. And it's happening on a Sunday, when a lot of people will probably be trying to come back home. Do you know anybody who's going to be traveling in the Sierra on Sunday? Make sure you give them a heads up on what to expect there. Big totals there for this time of year. Certainly not enough to make an impact on what we were looking at, but it'll at least delay that decrease. It'll slow it down a little bit, but that decrease is pretty inevitable the way things have already started going. All right, in the 7-day forecast, what comes next after that rain? We'll be done with it for the most part by Monday. Maybe a leftover shower on Monday morning, but it shouldn't be much. Don't leave out the fact that when we get that rain on Sunday, it's going to be colder. It'll be a bit windy. It'll be chilly. Some inland spots won't get out of the 50s all day. All right, guys, back over to you.